To make it short, it went well. I was very happy to have done that. Most of them I saw. I saw them play, and I speak to them, and I also try as much as I can not to go to them directly, but also to involve their parents, which was very important for me to understand the kind of angle they're coming from, because sometimes you might talk to them and you wouldn't know what you want. I think the parents helped a lot. Some of the ex-players too got themselves involved. The likes of ACN and others also helped. And it all went well. So I'm glad that I did that test. Thank you very much.
Good morning, and you're welcome to this event. The Magna Committee has not done much since we were put together, because we're waiting for the technical team to come up with their plans and programs. We are going to assist them administratively, mainly administratively, to get the technical job done. So we're waiting for such an event where the squad will be named, and we also will put together our activities to get the team going. But I would want to stress that we would want, the management committee would want to look at things seriously going forward, especially with player comportment, player discipline, in fact, discipline in the Black Stars in its entirety. So the code of conduct for becoming a Black Star player is going to be put into force. This is what we are working on seriously. And when the boys assemble for the first assignment against Sudan, they will be briefed and they will be made to admit and conform to the code of conduct. We believe that football is a team sport. You cannot over rely on individuals, one person or the other. They will have to work collectively. And the discipline that exists, that would exist amongst them, is key to the success of the team. We have just started, but we hope with your support, especially the media support, it is important for the team to stay together and be successful. So let's see what happens with the first encounter. Thank you.
Sulte Varigem, Belgium, Nicolas Opoku, Amiel, France, Joseph Aidu, Celta Vigo, Spain, Kassim Nuhu, Fortuna Düsseldorf, Germany, Habib Mohamed, Asante Kotoko, Ghana, Mubarak Wakasu, Jiangsu Sunny, China, Alfred Duncan, Florentina, Italy, Idrissou Baba, Real Mallorca, Spain, Thomas Partey, Atletico Madrid, Spain, Kudus Mohamed, FC Nordjylland, Denmark, Christopher Henry Ade, Paragon, Germany, Tariq Fosu, Brentford, England, Andrew Ayew, Swansea, England, Samuel Wusu, Al-Faha, Saudi Arabia, Eugene Ansah, Hapoel Ra'anana, Israel, Richmond Kwachiyado, West Ham Belgrade, Serbia, Jordan Ayew, Crystal Palace, okay, and lastly, Yahya Mohamed, Ghana. First of all, European main players, and I think it's necessary for us to let you know the names. Alisson Adjoku, Strasbourg. Francis Anouzou, Anderlecht. Ruben Quartin, Bordeaux. Brian Bobby, Ayas. Derek Lucassen, Anderlecht. Jeremy Doku, Anderlecht. Elisha Owusu, Ghent FC. Those players are players we will constantly work on them. They will not be available now, but I believe that the FA has taken over this initiative to make sure they get on board. There are two players who are eligible to play, and the names are Alexander Chiku and Elisha Owusu. Management is working hard to get them on board. Thank you very much. Pass the ball, quick move to attack, and we'll be able to get to, also to be able to create chances. I want players who are disciplined, strictly into our tactical play. Players who do not do things that has been discussed within the domain of the team. Always be in sort of. I wouldn't say trouble, but you find yourself. We've got to be disciplined. One of the things that I want to do is just change the attitude of the players. You know, there are things that we've done in the past that is not, doesn't look right. We just have to change our path. My philosophy is going to be that we're going to be an offensive oriented team. Thank you. Don't know anything about us, you know, and I think it's important for us to encourage them to come here and see. What is going on here? Recently, there was this trip where Americans are coming to back to their year of return. Maybe it's up to them now to come back to see. What I meant is that they're willing to come, of course, but they don't know what it is. You know, and I think we've been able to work players just like Otto Addo, Kevin Prince Boateng, Hans Sampaio, myself, Kufuor, and Anthony Bafo were involved for all those guys because we were there to talk to them, to educate them about Ghana. These guys don't have that. And that is why I meant by saying maybe it might take a bit of time. Thank you. You have to go back to the time I was playing, to the time I decided to coach. It's been a lesson, it's been a journey. And this journey, I wouldn't say has come to an end because I'm last as no. Last as is part of the dream, and I'm honored, I'm blessed to have had this opportunity, and I don't have to tell about it, based on my knowledge. The feeling is good, you know, it's good. It tells me I'm doing something, and I need to be said, well, I'm encouraging to me, and I need to work hard. This is not my last stop, and so I will do it and do it to the fullest. So the creator calls me. Thank you. The way we want to play, players we believe that are committed, players who have shown over the years that over the months or years that they are good and capable of playing. I must say, somebody like Kasim, I'm sure somebody will ask why is he in the team, he's not doing well in Europe. But he showed a lot of commitment when he comes down here. And sometimes we need to close our eyes on the performance abroad. Yes, it's important, but how have the boy performed when he's here? And he's done well. And this is the reason, and also we try as much as the style of play also is part of it. The other thing is that I wouldn't want to change the team entirely. It would be a big mistake. You know, I think if you look at the squad, majority of these guys were part of South Africa match, the last match we played, and it's a continuation of where Mr. Appiah left, and I want to continue from there. Thank you. We considered him to be part of the squad, but now the last games we played, we had Razak in as an assistant and to assist Ufori, and then Felix Annan as well. Felix is out, and we brought in Atta. It's all about the continuation of what we did in the previous match. We want to continue with that. And so that would be the reason. But he's been considered part of the day, we'll look at it. I think we have the data, okay? We need this data, we have a number of players. I wanted 40 now, it's going over 40. And we want to maintain that squad. Why? Because we don't want to do unnecessary changes. I'm not a type of person who is kind of changing things. Or I think as long as they stay together, play together, they get to know each other very well. So I really want to change it up and down. But those who, for instance, are not here, there are people, I will have to be fair and give all those guys the chances to play. Of course, there are qualification matches, there are friendly matches, and all those things we'll factor it in and make sure we get those unknown or those who have been bad and never, you know, been able to get a chance again to play. One of the reasons is why I even school, I went to a shop, to talk to shop and see the reason why he's not coming. And it was an open discussion which he made it clear to me why, but of course I cannot say that yet. So yes, we consider all those things and make sure that we will not have quantity but quality. This is the national team, and it's important we do that, keep these guys and give them a fair chance.
What about the criteria?
Of course, you have to be active, actively playing. And, but sometimes you need to, like I spoke about Wakasu, you know, he's played a couple of friendly matches, but it's not enough. But he is, you know, but the main thing is we've got to be active, we've got to be playing there, week in, week out.
I think it was impressive. We should give the coach the benefit of the doubt. Today is his first presser. He's done extremely well. The players, I think that selection of players to the national team can never be fair because everybody has his opinion. Some of the journalists are PR for some of the players, so they want to do their bidding. The coach has the final authority. Whatever he says is final. So we should give him the benefit of the doubt. And let's hope that the team will win the doubleheader for us.